talked about C.J. Beathard. We'll get our chance to see him in just a moment. Desmond King awaiting the kickoff in an absolutely jam-packed and electric Kinnick Stadium. Interesting to watch him in the matchup with Lucas LeGrand replacing Daniels at center. Beathard off play action with all kinds of time. Wide open is Vandenberg with a spin down to the five. Straight drop for Beathard. Good protection in the end zone. Touchdown. George Kittle in for six. Play action. Beathard over the middle, wide open in the end zone. Touchdown, Ekrem Wadley.
And that was the old simple wheel route coming out of the backfield for Wadley. Great play action fake right now by C.J. Beathard, and the offensive line staying low and selling it.
Pressure on him, like, put it on me, I'll get it done. You got to like that for your quarterback.
On second and goal, Lanning with time. Now the pocket collapses as he's down. Jaleel Johnson with the sack.
It's not there. You've got to get rid of it because you want to get points on the board.
Look, one of those three receivers at the top go the corner route.
Lanning under pressure, in trouble, and he's sacked. On first down, Beathard and company just shy of the 35. Toss play, now the reverse to Vandenberg. Vandenberg with Beathard out in front. Vandenberg got the corner, down the sideline and out of bounds inside the Cyclone 40.
I like this, they're going a little bit more man here. Pressure picked up. Beathard on the roll for the end zone. Jump ball plucked out of the air by Vandenberg for the touchdown. That is all on the throw. Great catch, but great placement of that ball because the coverage was all over him, Chuck.
I think C.J. Beathard throws as well as anybody in college football on the run. In fact, that's where he's most dangerous, in my opinion.
Beside Matt Millen, Chuck Long, Lisa Byington's on the field. I'm Kevin Kugler. Our entire BTN crew here under the lights in Iowa City. Perfect night for football. And a great start for the Hawkeyes with a 21-3 lead over their in-state rivals from Ames. Beathard to the air on first down, down the sideline. Leaping grab by Vandenberg. He does it again. And Vandenberg all the way out to the 44-yard line.
There's Greg Davis right there in the middle.
On second and goal, driving for the goal line. Touchdown, Iowa. Landing under pressure, he's going to be dropped.
That's
now the clock rolled down to zero, but I'm not so sure that the clock ran out. They're sending the Hawkeyes to the locker room. Everybody's headed to the locker room. It looked like there was still time left, but neither team's going to be on here to care. 28-3, Iowa leading at the half.
Third down and three for the Hawkeyes.
Four-man pressure. Toss down the sideline. What a catch by Vandenberg. The throw dropped in the bucket, and Vandenberg scooped it up right over the shoulder with DeAndre Payne on his backside.
Play of 25 yards or more for Vandenberg tonight. Quick toss over the middle. Room to run up the middle for Vandenberg, and he's down inside the 25 to the 21. Everett Edwards on the tackle. And two tight ends on the right side of the line towards the bottom of your screen. Ekrem Wadley with the carry.
Little slither inside. Breaks a tackle. Oh. With a spin. Wadley down to the three.
These two backs, Daniels and Wadley, combined for over 9 yards per carry in the opener. Wadley again. Stops on a dime and takes it in for six.
He made change on that dime. There's two nickels out there. You can't find that. Chuck, that kind of skill right there, you can't find.
I mean,
you have it or you don't have it. Akram Wadley's had enough. Keep in mind, a few years ago, he was heavily in the doghouse. I mean, he was scratching fleas. That's how far he was in.
He was going to defensive back.
Exactly. He wanted to move
defensive back.
Yeah. And except for an injury, he might be opposite Desmond King right now.
Landing on the roll.
And it's intercepted by Niemann. Niemann with the pick. And the Hawkeyes have it back at the 43.
And a lot of time, your competitiveness gets you in that position.
Daniels on second down. A cutback.
And Daniels with a lot of green space. Daniels turning on the Jets. Touchdown, Iowa.
Out the lights. Party's over. He went back door on that one, Chuck. Everybody flowed strong side. His eyes took him back. And then he hit a burst at about the 15-yard line to get himself into the end zone.
And that's going to be the final play of this version of the Cy-Hawks series. Dominance tonight, the largest margin of victory in the series since Iowa won 63-20 back in 1997. And tonight, it was all Iowa in the Battle of Iowa and Iowa State. 42-3. The Hawkeyes dominate the Cyclones, and they keep the Cy-Hawk trophy here in Iowa City. Impressive performance tonight for their 14th straight regular season win.
Yeah, and an impressive performance by the man right in the front and middle of your camera right there, and that was C.J. Beathard. I thought Beathard came out and played exceptionally well from the start of it all the way through, Chuck.
And you mentioned offensive line, pad level, coming off the ball in unison. Everything's won in the trenches, as you know, Matt, and Iowa definitely won in the trenches with their offense. Offensive line and defensive line.
They got a pretty good football team here.
Pretty good.
It's gonna be interesting to see, because they're gonna get better as the season goes on.
Well, no
Beathard
question.
Will lead this pack, but they have a good running game and a good offensive line. It's gonna be fun to watch this team.
Beathard tonight, 235 yards and three touchdowns through the air. He also rushed for a touchdown. That'll do it from Kinnick Stadium. Our final score, 42-3. Iowa with a win. Coming up, Dave Jerry and Howard will wrap up a busy week number two of Big Ten.